Hello, everybody. This is Chuck. It's great to be with you today. Soy el abogado Charles Cook. Qué placer de estar con ustedes hoy día. Una de las cosas que mencioné, one of the things I mentioned, and we're going to do this in English and Spanish today because we're going to make a couple of announcements. Una cosa que prometí es que hoy día anunciaremos que ya tenemos los ganadores de Navidad con Cook Baxter. Hemos notificado a los tres ganadores y puesto ellos en el horario para entrevistas. Van a empezar sus casos y por todos que sometieron sus peticiones, sus cartas. Te vamos a hacer una consulta gratis para averiguar qué más podemos hacer, si hay opciones, qué opciones hay y qué sería para ayudarte. Entonces, estarás contactado por nuestra oficina esta semana, cada persona que mandó una entrada, y haremos las consultas gratis con nuestros abogados para averiguar qué opciones tendrían. Pero los ganadores ya vamos a empezar con su caso. Y Dustin y yo estaremos entrevistándolos. I was just announcing in Spanish the winners of our Christmas with Cook Baxter. As you know, we invited people who are struggling to send in their letters about their cases and about how they're struggling. And we have taken three pro bono cases from that. And everybody's getting a free consult so we can figure out what options. Because sometimes people tell us stuff that doesn't make sense or we need more information. So we're going to interview everybody and see what other options that might exist for who else we can help. But I want to thank everybody who participated this year in Cook Baxter, Christmas with Cook Baxter. Las cosas que están en el título hoy día son muy sencillas. The things that are in the title today are very simple. What is going on with immigration? ¿Qué pasó con inmigración? What's going on? I'll do it in Spanish first and then in English. A mí me parece que la reforma ya se murió, a mí me parece. No veo un proceso viable por lo cual pueden traer la BBB con las provisiones de inmigración por un voto que sacará los números de votos suficientes para pasarlo en el Senado. I do not see how the Build Back Better plan is going to get the votes necessary to pass in the Senate. And if the Build Back Better plan with the immigration provisions in it does not pass, it doesn't pass. De este punto, si no pasa la reforma, si no en la reforma para dar a lo mínimo permisos de trabajo a los indocumentados y recuperar las visas de años antecedentes, ¿qué pasará después de esto? So if the bill, which had work permits for the undocumented, some of the undocumented, not all of them, and recovery of visas and the idea of keeping visas within the categories, if that doesn't pass in the Build Back Better bill, then what? ¿Qué pasa después? Well, hay varias propuestas individuales que en lo cual los republicanos tal vez uniría. Pero probablemente no uniría en permisos de trabajo por los indocumentados porque odian a los indocumentados. Todavía no entiendo por qué los republicanos, gente que son latinos, votan por republicanos que tienen familias que son indocumentados, pero así es. So what we may see are some standalone bills. Republicans will probably never support, maybe one or two, but not 10, will not support a legalization program. They're not going to support a visa program, we're not going to support work permits, people on undocumented, they're just not going to do it. They don't want immigrants here. That's the party policy. That's Donald Trump. They don't want immigrants, period, end of story. So they think that they just keep making people's lives miserable from now until the end of time, they'll leave. Of course, they're not. They're just making their own lives miserable, but they don't care. They just don't care. But we do believe that there probably are enough Republican votes to get a bill passed that recaptures old visas and restructures how visas are saved going forward. We do believe that may pass. And that is what we hope the Democrats will go through in the next 2 or 3 months. There is probably only 2 or 3 months to get this done. Solamente hay 2, 3, 4 meses para pasar esas cosas. Porque después de mayo ya elecciones ya están corriendo y no van a votar en cosas duras. También, por supuesto, tenemos los votos en enero, en noviembre, después de la elección. Tal vez podrían pasar algo en aquel entonces. We also, of course, have the lame duck session, the session that begins after the elections in November, when everybody's lost. They may go ahead and pass something then, because it won't matter at that point. You know, they're not running for re-election. Many people have lost, especially Democrats. Republicans are coming in. This will be their last chance. And I will tell you that some of the best immigration legislation that's passed in the last 30 years has passed in a lame duck session. So that may be all that we have left, unfortunately. La otra cosa que quise hablar hoy día era acerca de los que están esperando permisos de trabajo que son atrasados. Ya un año, 11 meses, 12 meses, 13 meses. Inmigración está atrasada. I mean, ellos no están enfocando en hacerlo. A la ley eso no le importa. Pero ellos han puesto un cambiocito en la ley, en la regla, la política, mejor dicho, que los con permisos de trabajo pidiendo extensiones que son trabajadores en salud, que trabajan como tutor, enfermera, en cualquier parte que afecta a la salud pública. Ellos pueden pedir una rápida extensión de su visa. Hay un proceso de hacerlo y, por supuesto, podemos ayudarte a hacerlo. The other big announcement, of course, and this is really thanks to my friend Greg Siskin, who tweeted about it. He actually retweeted our other friend, his attorney that works for them, at least Tavis partner, that why aren't you expediting healthcare workers? So healthcare workers that have pending EAD extensions can request an expedite by calling the 1-800 useless number. They will then call you back and go through a series of questions with you to try to get that expedited. So if you are a healthcare worker waiting on EAD extension, call the 1-800 useless number and you will be good. Keep in mind that if you want to do a consult here with us, just pop on the consult and llámame, call me, you know, llama hoy día. Si quieres la consulta, llama hoy día. Estamos haciendo consultas por todos los que tienen preguntas de inmigración. So let's take a look at some of our comments today. What we have, tenemos un comentario de ¿y qué pasó con DACA? Todavía es una buena pregunta. Con DACA, what happened with DACA? Lo que pasó con DACA es que ya terminaron de recibir comentario sobre la reextensión de DACA. Siguiendo la regla que no siguieron antes, la razón que el corte lo paró, el fin del mes, y hice la pregunta a la administración, ¿cuándo van a activar la regla? Y no hay respuesta. You know? Yo tengo la expectación los fines de febrero, pero eso es lo que creo. So when will DACA become active? Remember, the reason that the judge, I think, improperly stopped DACA and was held up on appeal for doing so, was that the administration never followed, this is Obama, never followed the Administrative Procedures Act in creating DACA. So now they have. And they finished taking comments. And you would think that these guys would be on this like a fly on a pile of poop, but they're not. And so I'm thinking by the end of February, we will have DACA back, is what I think. That's my estimate on this. Carlos Ruiz Justiano, thank you for your time. Is there a chance to sue the U.S. Embassy in Peru for more than 2 years delay in issuing visas for F2A? Yes, I would love to sue the U.S. consulate in Lima. If you want to email me privately, let me put my email up. You can email me with the details because it is illegal what they have been doing in basically not doing F2As and only doing marriage-based cases. That's all they've been doing, and that's illegal. We actually won that issue already with Judge Mehta, and I'm more than happy to bring that lawsuit again, especially if you've got 100 plaintiffs, it makes it a lot easier to get that done. Thank you, Carlos. Let's see. Malina Ross, hola, Mr. Cook. What happens with DV 2020 in 1995? Oh, para regresar. En español, si está esperando entrevista en el consulado en Lima, este hombre está preguntando si podemos llevar una litigación, una queja contra la inmigración y contra el consulado. Y sí, podemos hacerlo. Mándame un email. Melina, what happened? When does the years? As I've said repeatedly, Melina, in these podcasts, I don't know. They're not telling us. They did mention that it will take them 6 months from October to update their computers, their software to make this happen. So maybe April. Tal vez van a empezar las visas 2022 y 2021, 2020 en abril, porque ellos dijeron que tienen que cambiar sus sistemas electrónicos para ponerlo, para hacerlo. No los creo, pero así es. Igli Kukli, Merry Christmas to you. The Gomez case, no news. No hay noticias por Gomez. Sergio Galán Maldonado. Sergio. Entré con visa en 2000, me quedé hasta 2006, salí en este año y regresé en 2007 con la misma visa, pero regresé en el 94, ya no volví a salir. ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué puede agregar con mi hija de 21 años? Sí, podemos hacer la petición. Hay obviamente problemas que tendremos que justificar, pero no tienes una prohibición por vida. Todavía podemos hacer la aplicación. Una cosa que eres elegible es entraste con visa. Si entraste con visa, su hija es residente o ciudadana, ella te puede ayudar. Entonces, llame por la cita. El modo de hacer esto es así. Mande un email o, si quieres, llame el número hoy, ahorita, y le fijen la cita. Le fijen la cita para hablar conmigo o uno de mis abogados. Okay? Tamil Tamuna, what happened to 2022 winners? We are literally no interviews. Yes, we know. And that's why we're suing them. Tamo, we will be sending out the notice later today on Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, for all those who want to be plaintiffs. They have continued to follow the rule that their policy that to not do DVs cases. That's illegal. The judgment has already ruled it's illegal. We will file to recapture all those unused numbers done while it's illegal and force them to get these done. So more than happy to sue. That's what's going on. Why aren't the winners in Georgia called for an interview? As I just said, because they have no prioritization. They're illegally following the supposedly canceled prioritization memo, which is clearly still in effect, which is why we're suing. So pay attention to our Twitter page and our Facebook page and our YouTube page and our LinkedIn page later today, and that of Greg and Aaron as well. Do I have to go to Juarez if I'm married to a citizen and have an illegal entry? Yes, you do. Unless you're not from Mexico, and then you don't go to Juarez. But if you're from Mexico, you have to do that unless you are protected by the 245i law. That is, you were here prior to 2000, October, December 2000, and you have a petition filed for you before that date. Or if you have DACA and you travel and reenter on DACA, which is also what we do to help a lot of people. How is our new Solicitor General? Who record on immigration? Nothing. We have no real record on immigration. And really, the decision, while the decision comes from the Solicitor General about whether to appeal the DV cases, the reality is it's a political decision. And if Biden will live up to his promises, he won't appeal them. So that's what we're hoping will happen. All right. But the State Department really wants to appeal. They really, really want to appeal because they want the power not to issue visas. That's true. You hear me say it here? They want the power not to issue visas. All right. Many of you know in my little note, I said I actually teach now on Wednesdays, unfortunately. No, I mean, I love teaching. So yo soy profesor de ley in la Escuela de Ley de Emory. I am a professor of law at Emory University. And I teach I teach immigration and advanced immigration classes. Yo enseño las clases de inmigración y las clases avanzadas de inmigración a los estudiantes de ley en la Escuela de Ley de Emory. Y ya enseño los miércoles en la mañana y en la tarde. Entonces enseño de 10:30 to 12:30 y 2 to 4. So I teach from 10:30 to 12:30. Then I also teach from 2 to 4. So I can't do my Facebook Lives on Wednesday at 2. I have to do them at 1. So that's what I'm doing today, is that Facebook Live for that reason. Okay. I have a case number. When do you think I will enter the interview? I don't have any idea. I don't know. Hopefully soon. Hopefully, if we sue them, we might have to be a plaintiff to get interviewed. Will the recapture bill pass? Even the Senate do not agree on immigration section. Well, that's the thing. The recapture bill, if it's separate, has a very good chance of passing, in my opinion, because a similar bill has passed previously. Back in 2004, there was a huge recapture bill that passed. So Republicans actually sponsored that, and Democrats supported it. So we'll see. Patricia, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo estás? Buenos días. ¿Cuánto tiempo tarda una visa de estudiante? Si después de terminado la carrera, ¿se puede cambiar la condición de la visa? La visa de estudiante es mientras que estás estudiando. Puedes estudiar por décadas, si quiere. Después de estudiar, usted va a ser dado, si gradúa, le dan un permiso de trabajo, la OPT, por un año o 3 años si está en un área de ciencias, o puede sacar una visa H1B en el sorteo. Cindy, so if I apply for DACA, well, you can't apply for DACA, first of all, Cindy. If you were otherwise eligible and you didn't apply for DACA for whatever reason, but now are still eligible, and when it comes back and you apply for DACA and you get it, then you can apply for a travel document, which you then travel, come back in, and then get your green card through your spouse. What about DV 2021? No news. Please expedite the U.S. Embassy in Georgia. I will. You hire me and we'll sue them. How about that? I think that's a good idea. You hire me, we'll get it done. Category change to DVD lottery. You mean a DV lottery, because a DVD lottery is for my old songs. You don't want those. Scan request room still silent. What do you think? I don't really know what you're talking about. What scan requests? I don't know what you're talking about, Tomo. When will the vote on the BBB? I don't think there's going to be a vote on the BBB, Zaki. I don't. I really don't. I don't think they're going to vote on it. Licenciado, ¿qué con los que hicieron DACA el año pasado? Los que están pendientes todavía. Esperamos a la administración de Biden de reabrir, como expliqué. Estamos esperando, yo creo, en febrero. A fin de febrero tendremos todo. Ojalá. Cindy, no hay de qué. Suerte con esto. Sería un placer ayudarte. Now, of course, you can, you know, if you have questions, call for a consult. You can also email me. Email me here. You can DM me, give us a like, Twitter, you know, give us a big thumbs up. Y por supuesto, si quieres hablar conmigo, hay que tomar el teléfono y llamarme. Okay, ya hemos, no tenemos otras preguntas. Entonces voy a preparar por mi clase que viene prontito y te veré el próximo miércoles a la 1, donde estaré vivo. Y hasta entonces, que Dios le bendiga. We'll see you guys next week at 1 o'clock. Until then, get God protect you. Thank you. Bye-bye.